Good morning children, how are you all? I hope you are all fine at home. In this video, we are going to see grammar for grade 6 to 8. The topics going to be covered in this video are adjectives, adverbs and diary entry. Adjectives, adverbs and diary entry. Let us move into the video now. First, we are going to see about adjectives. An adjective describes a noun or a pronoun. What is an adjective? It describes a noun or a pronoun. So it describes in three ways: of what kind the noun is, which one, and how many. It answers all these three questions. See, for example, happy dog. In this, what kind of dog it is? It is a happy dog. Which boy? Tired boy. How many girls? 7 girls. Can you understand? Yes. We saw the gray elephant at the zoo. Then ask, what words describe the nouns? What kind? Which one? How many? Here the gray elephant describes the elephant. The word gray describes the word elephant. So it shows what kind of elephant it is. It is a gray color elephant. So first of all, to find an adjective, we should locate the nouns first. So what are all the nouns in the sentence? Children and park. So the word happy describes a noun, children. So can you see three happy children? In this, the word three and happy describes the noun, children. The donkey stepped on my large hat. The donkey stepped on my large hat. So what are all the nouns here? Donkey and hat. So here you don't have any describing word. But see here, large hat. So what kind of hat it is? It is a large hat. The child was brave. The child was brave. So how was the brave? How was the child? He was brave. So what kind of child he is? He is a brave child. It answers the question, what kind? Can you find the adjectives? First, find the nouns. The rabbit followed the slow turtle. So here nouns are turtle and rabbit. Yes. The word slow describes the noun turtle. Then ask what words describe the nouns. What kind of noun it is. So again, here the slow turtle. So what kind of turtle it is? It is a slow turtle. Can you find the adjectives in this? First find the nouns. He found 2 pennies on the ground. Then ask what words describe the nouns. What kind? Which one? How many? Here, how many pennies? 2 pennies. It is 2 pennies. So how many pennies he found? He found 2 pennies. So how many? It answers the question, how many? Can you find the adjectives in this? First find the nouns. The children heard the loud bell. So bell and children are nouns. So the word loud is a describing word which describes the noun bell. Then ask what words describe the nouns. What words describe the nouns? Loud describes the noun. So what kind of bell it is? It is a loud bell. So observe the given picture, children. In this, can you see the small girl? Yes. So can you describe this girl? Think. So you can answer in the basis of what kind, which one, how many and how much. Adjectives. Adjectives are modifiers. They modify nouns. They tell us more about nouns or pronouns. Adjectives can be located by asking questions to the nouns like what kind, which one, how many and how much. Can you see here? I saw a girl. I saw a girl. This shows how many girls it is. One girl. I saw a pretty girl. What kind of girl he is? She is pretty girl. Christina bounced the round basketball. So here, how was the basketball? It is round. The colorful butterfly was on the flower. What kind of butterfly? Colorful. So in this module, we are going to see the position of adjectives, where the adjective should be placed. So adjectives are usually positioned before the noun they describe. For example, the slimy creature crept up my bare leg. Can you see? The slimy creature crept up my bare leg. Can you see? It is placed always before or after, before the noun. Okay, mostly it is placed before the noun or the pronoun. Can you see? The slimy creature crept up my bare leg. So when an adjective describes a noun, it comes before the noun. We watched the orange sunset. Can you see? It is placed before the noun sun. Here, before the noun leg. We cannot use adjectives before pronouns because adjectives describe a subject pronoun. That is, it is describing the subject pronoun. So hot it, we cannot say. So you should use at the end of the sentence. It is hot. She is short. How is she? She is short. So before pronoun you cannot use a adjective, but before a noun you can use adjective. The same way you can use nouns also. See, the sun was bright. Instead of it, the sun was bright. They look cheerful. Can you understand, children? It should be placed before the noun. In sometimes it can also be placed at the end of the sentence. So now we are going to see about the kinds of adjectives. How many kinds of adjectives are there? 5 kinds. One is adjectives of quality, adjectives of quantity, possessive adjectives, adjectives of number, demonstrative adjectives. So explanation. Kinds of adjectives. Adjectives of quality. First of all, we are going to see the adjectives of quality. How many types? I will come again. Adjectives of quality, adjectives of quantity, possessive adjectives, adjectives of number, demonstrative adjectives. Let us see about all these 5 kinds in detail. So adjectives that describe the nature, color, size, age, shape, and origin and material of the noun or pronoun are called adjectives of quality. So it shows the color, size, age, shape, origin, material, everything. It shows the quality of the noun. Okay, it is called adjectives of quality. They answer the question what kind it is of. For example, the kind woman took the puppy home. The kind woman took the puppy home. Here, the kind is the word describes how, what kind of person the woman is. So, 2 more examples are given. The ancient statue stands on the hilltop. Adjective, ancient describes the noun statue. She is efficient and honest. What kind of person she is? She is efficient and honest. Adjectives of number. Adjectives of number. Adjectives tell about the number of the noun are called adjectives of number. It answers the question how many. So before that, I am going to tell what is oxymoron. The word oxymoron. So what is an oxymoron? It is a phrase that combines contradictory adjectives with nouns. For example, it is a cruel joke. Horror comic. So horror is different. Cruel is different. Joke is entirely different. So the phrase combines both different contradictory things in a same word. See, horror comics, liquid gas, plastic glasses, liquid metal. Yes, easy problem. Can you see these, children? Yes. Can you come up with some more examples of oxymorons on your own? Yes. Adjectives of number are used with countable nouns. It can be used with countable nouns. For example, two bottles of sherbet. Sherbet. We bought two bottles of sherbet. There were many people in the room. There were many people in the room. How many? These four topics are not very easy. It not only comes with 1, 2, 3. Many is also included. Included with what? The adjectives of number. Next, we are going to see adjectives of quantity. Quantity shows the amount, but adjectives of number shows how many numbers. That answers the question how many. The quantity, adjectives of quantity answers the question how much. See, adjectives that tell about amount of noun are called adjectives of quantity. They are the question how much. They answer the question how much. Adjectives of quantity may be used with both countable as well as uncountable nouns. See here, some rice is still there in the pot. How much rice? Some rice. The car did not cost me much money. Here, rice is an uncountable noun, but money is a countable noun. Money can be counted, right? Yes. It was enough. It was enough. Next, the fourth type, demonstrative adjective. Adjectives that point out or specify the noun that follows them are called demonstrative adjectives. For example, this, that, these, those. So many things will come like the determiners that you have learnt last time. This, that, these, those, and the. So all these are also called as determiners. Right, children? Don't get confused. Okay. Demonstrative adjectives always come before nouns. Possessive adjectives. Adjectives that indicate who possess the noun that follows are called possessive adjectives. For example, our house. Okay. This house is ours. Can you see the difference? Yes. Our house is near the river. Your house is on the hilltop. His farm is beyond the hill. So it shows the possession, one's possession. So it is called as possessive adjectives. My mother is a doctor. Their mother is a teacher. Your name is written here. Her name is not there. So can you see? It is placed before the noun. So children, you have found all the types of adjectives. Now, can you be able to describe this creature? Yes. So, underline the adjectives in these sentences and write their kind. Some vegetables can be grown in large pots. Some vegetables can be grown in large pots. So, I will do one for you. See here. So before the noun vegetables, here you can see one adjective, some. So what kind of adjective it is? Yes, it is adjectives of quantity. Adjectives of quantity. Next. So here before the noun pots, you can find the adjective large. So same way you have to do the remaining exercise. Will you be able to do? Yes. Organic food is being sold in 4 outlets. Organic food is being sold in 4 outlets. So here you can find 2 nouns. So here all the answers has been given. This is how you have to complete it. So you should underline adjective and then write what kind of adjective it is. Okay, children? Yes. So can you see? This one is adjectives of quality and this is adjectives of quantity. So 10 exercises has been given to you. Next, you should know the difference between possessive adjectives and possessive pronouns. Okay, it is important not to confuse both possessive pronoun and possessive adjective. The pronouns only we are using it as adjectives, but the place where it is, it has to be positioned matters. Okay. Possessive adjectives: my, your, his, her, our, their, its. Possessive pronouns: mine, your, his, hers, our, theirs, its. Did you see the difference between them? Yes. So possessive adjectives are placed before nouns, but possessive pronouns are used in the place of nouns. Can you understand the difference? This is placed before nouns, but these are used in the place of nouns. My bag is missing. Their dog has been found. Her name is Saya. Can you see everything is placed before the noun? Here, the bag is mine. In the place of a noun, it is used in the place of a noun. They have found theirs. So here an exercise is given for you to identify whether it is possessive adjective or possessive pronoun. Stella, how long did your color pencils last? A little over a month. And yours? Can you see? So you have to circle the possessive adjectives. First one has been done for you. Okay, you have to circle the possessive adjectives because it is placed before the color pencils, noun. Okay. And yours? It comes in the place of a noun. Yes. Stella dash lasted only for 15 days. Mine lasted only for 15 days. It is a possessive pronoun. Did you share your pencils with someone? So try to fill in this dialogue and find out whether it is possessive pronoun or possessive adjective. I'll give you a few minutes in order to complete this exercise. Shall I reveal the answer to you? Yes. Can you see? All the encircled words are possessive pronouns and the others are encircled one are possessive adjectives and the others are possessive pronouns. Next, we are moving into the last type, interrogative adjective. So words like whose, which and what, that are used before nouns to ask questions are called interrogative adjectives. Whose, which, what? Whose pen are you looking for? Which house is yours? What method are you following? The same rules which we use for possessive adjectives, same thing we should follow here also. The question word should be placed in the before the noun. Can you see? Yes. So can you be able to rearrange the jumbled words to frame questions, children? See, I'll do one for you. Movies like do, which, you. You can change it into a readable sentence. See, which movies do you like? Which movies do you like? So same way you should change everything into an interrogative adjective with sentence. See the answer. Which movies do you like? Second one, pet whose lost is. Whose pet is lost? Which building do you live in? You are whose medal wearing? Whose medal are you wearing? Which village has been flooded? Whose turn it is? Which neighbor did you help? What books do you want to buy? Whose rucksack was it? Which cakes do you like? Next, interrogative adjectives and interrogative pronouns. All interrogative adjectives, whose, which and what, can also be used as interrogative pronouns. So interrogative adjectives are always used before nouns. Whose house are you visiting? Which car do you like? What time is it now? So whose is this? Can you see? Should know the difference between interrogative adjectives and interrogative pronoun. Like possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. So here it is placed before the noun. Here it comes in the place of noun. Can you see? Whose is this? Which is the largest ocean? What are you doing? Understood, children? Yes. So write whether the underlined words are adjectives or pronouns. Yes, you have to find whether these words are adjectives or pronouns. Here you have combined with the possessive pronouns and interrogative pronouns, adjectives. Okay, so let us see whether they are adjectives or pronouns. So first one, it is an adjective. The lighter box is hers. It is a pronoun. These skates are mine. It is an adjective. What would you like to eat? It is a pronoun. They have liked your story. It is an adjective. Her hair is longer than yours. It is a. Now let us move into the next topic, children. This is about adverbs. Adverbs are the words that describe the verbs, adverbs, and the adjectives in a sentence. It is mainly used to describe the verb in a sentence. Understood, children? As adjectives describe the noun, adverbs describe the verb, adverbs and adjectives as well. Understood, children? Yes. It is divided into five types. One is adverb of time, adverb of place, adverb of manner, adverb of frequency, and adverb of degree. Let us see what is adverb of time. It describes the time of the action take place, right? See, in the example first, I played cricket yesterday. When did you play cricket? It is yesterday. It describes the verb play. When the action was taken place? It was taken place yesterday. So in this, the word yesterday is the adverb. I was watching television program at 2 p.m. In this, the time is mentioned at 2 p.m. So, watching television. Watching is the action and it was described at when it was happened. So, it is the adjective, adverb is 2 p.m. I woke up early in the morning. I woke up early in the morning. Here, early in the morning. Altogether, it makes when I woke up. Right? So the action waking up has been described with the words early in the morning. So here it describes or provides more information about the place in which the action has taken place. Adverb of place. So it describes adverb of place, the action which has taken place in the place, about the place where it has taken place. So I went to the market. I went. So this going has been described where I am going. So that is to the market. I played cricket. So the verb play has been is described with the word school ground, where I was playing. Right? I will be flying abroad next month. So abroad shows the adverb of place and next month shows the adverb of time. Can you understand, children? Yes. Next is adverb of manner. Adverb of manner. It describes how well or worse the action has taken place. Whether it is beautifully taken place or whether it is worsely taken place, it doesn't matter. So if a word describes how the action has been taken place, so it is called adverb of manner. Example, I wrote all my exams well. I wrote all my exams well. Here the word well describes how I have written my exams. So the word well describes the verb. So it is the adverb of manner. The car moves swiftly. How the car moves? It moves very fastly. Swiftly means fastly. So, swiftly describes the movement of the car. He ran faster. How did he run? He ran very fast. I reached the spot soon. I reached the spot soon. So all these things describes how the action has been taken place in a sentence. Adverb of frequency. This is the next type, and this shows frequency means how often the action takes place. How often the action takes place. Example, I used to visit my uncle once in a month. Here the word once in a month describes how often I used to visit my uncle, right? Often she is late to school. Often she is late to school. She is late to school very often, right? He attends a meeting rarely. He attends a meeting rarely. He never comes to the meeting. Never means it doesn't happen at all. Rarely means at any time, after a very long time, once in a while, right? Next is adverb of degree. So it shows the intensity of the action. Intensity of the action. I am happy. In this word, happy has been described by extremely. How much intensity I am happy? I am extremely happy. The word extremely shows how intensity, what is the intensity of this happiness, right? So it is the adverb of degree. He was highly honored by them. He was highly honored. He was honored. So how he was honored? He was honored highly. He was really ashamed of it. He was ashamed. How much, right? So it shows the intensity of the action. So here I have given a list of words that can be added with ly and changed into adverbs. So abrupt means a verb or an adjective which can be changed into adverb by adding ly, right? So here is a list of words you can keep in your mind to enrich your vocabulary, right children? Yes. Abruptly. Repeat with me. Abruptly. Absently. Accusingly. Actually. Actually. Adversely. Amazingly. Angrily. Arrogantly. Bashfully. Beautifully. Boldly. Brightly. Calmly. Carefully. Cheaply. Carelessly. Certainly. Clearly, closely, commonly, coolly, correctly, crossly, dearly, delightfully, desperately, determinedly, doggedly, energetically, extremely, especially, exactly, excitedly, expertly, fairly, famously, ferociously, finally, freely, fully, generally, generously, gently, greedily, guiltily, harshly, heartily, heavily, helplessly, immediately, increasingly, innocently, jokingly, knowingly, lightly, madly, meaningfully, mentally, messily, mostly, nearly, neatly, nervously, nicely, outwardly, passionately, and perfectly. Right? There are even thousands of words with adverbs, children. So these are commonly used words which you can use in your own language in order to speak out very good and fluent English. Yes? So now we are moving into the writing part, children. It is diary entry. Last time we saw the notice writing, right? Yes. This diary entry is something, a piece of writing that has to be organized by date. Okay. The entries in your diary are how your train of thoughts run, what you feel, and what are your opinions about things in your life. It is nothing but writing your diary. How many of you have the habit of writing diary? Yes, many of you would have, right? So it is not sure that every day we should write. So whenever we have to put down our thoughts, right? Pin down our thoughts, we can use the diary and mention the date and you should write. So in short, you are writing about your days like you would tell it to a friend. So when you have an interesting day on the day, or particularly you want to share to somebody else, if you don't have someone who is trustworthy, right, we start writing diary. Yes or no? Yes. So the diary entry writing format contains only two things, that is date and day you are writing on, and the content that you have to write. Let us see what is the format of writing the diary. So this is the format of writing a diary, children. So you should mention the date, time, and you can call your diary dear diary, right? Or else instead of diary, you can give any name to your diary. Yes. So you can start writing the content, whatever happened on the day, which things you want to share, right? Yes. And your name at the end. So here is an example for you. See, I'll read out it for you and you can copy down in this in your classwork. So yesterday it was your first day in your new school. You made new friends, teachers were good to you, and you liked the infrastructure of the school. Write about your experiences and feelings about the new school in your diary, right? Okay. Let us start like this. Wednesday, 1st July 2021. Or 2020 or 2022 might be in future, right? So that's why they have given us XX. So in which day you are writing, you can mention that date. You can mention the time like this, 8:30 p.m. Diary entry. Sorry, dear diary. Today I joined my new school. It was very nice and exciting. My class teacher was very nice to me. She introduced me to the entire class. I sat with Neha, the monitor of the class. She helped me in every way possible. She gave me her notebooks, shared her lunch with me. She even helped me with my classwork. The best thing I liked about the school was the library. It was very big and spacious like us, right? Yes. I am a passionate reader and I found many books of my favorite authors. The computer lab was well equipped with the latest models of computers. I look forward to going to school tomorrow. Now I am not missing my old friends and my old school. Now I am going to sleep as I have to get up early in the morning to get ready to school. Bubbly. So you can write your name there. Understood, children? Yes. So this is a homework for you. Write a diary entry about a nightmare. Nightmare means a bad dream, okay, that made you to wake up from the sleep and how terrific it was. You have to write a diary entry. I hope you have understood how to write a diary entry. You do this homework as a practice, children. Yes, okay. And we have come to the end of the session, right? And thank you for watching the video and have a nice day. You have to regularly watch all the videos and try to learn at home, children. It is our bad time. We are not meeting soon. And let us pray to God. Soon the schools should be reopened and we shall learn in a classroom situation. Yes. Bye.